Wednesday for the three former Minneapolis police officers on the scene when George Floyd died.
Their inaction on the scene has prompted questions about the neck restraint used on George Floyd. With more on that and the charges in the case, here's Julie Unruh.
What we saw in the video, we have to be clear, was never categorized as a neck restraint in my time in training.
For 17 years, Dr. Sean Williams was a sworn police officer. The last 10 plus were in Minneapolis. He even trained officers as part of his job. He says without hesitation, the police manual dated from 2012 may have said neck restraints were part of Minneapolis's police training.
With this, I'm gonna wrap it around his neck.
But they should look more like this.
I'm squeezing with my front arm and pushing with my back arm. Just like that.
Williams says these techniques are used to temporarily cut off blood flow to the carotid artery, not airflow to the trachea. It's used to control an aggressive subject, and not all officers there choose to use this technique.
That was not a trained technique ever. I can't make it any clearer than that. That was a lapse in judgment, the way I look at it, from a personal standpoint.
Still, records show the Minneapolis Police Department used controversial neck restraints over 40 times in the past 5 years. This is police departments across the country are banning them, including in parts of Southern California.
My experience in dealing with police officers in the 90s and into 2000 and beyond, that is something that is not taught.
Not taught in Chicago, says Joe Roddy. He used to prosecute cases at 26th and California. In his experience, charging former Minneapolis officer Derek Chauvin within days of George Floyd's last breath and the other three officers on the scene 9 days after Floyd died is a reasonable span of time.
They wanted to get it right, and they did it as quickly as they could.
Getting the charges right is important. Back in 2015, off-duty Chicago police officer Dante Servin was found not guilty of shooting and killing Rekia Boyd. He was charged with involuntary manslaughter. The judge back then said there was no evidence of reckless conduct, and Servin walked out of court a free man. Talking to witnesses, gathering evidence, reviewing videotape, and more. It takes time, Roddy says, despite the sentiment inside the emotional Minneapolis memorial for George Floyd.
But it seems like some in the criminal justice system have a problem looking at a tape and knowing there's probable cause, and it takes a long time for you to go and do what you see that you need to do.
You may remember it took more than a year for former Chicago police officer Jason Van Dyke to be charged in the death of Laquan McDonald, an on-duty white officer who, in the end, was convicted of firing 16 shots at a black teen. Wednesday, charges did come down against the remaining three officers on the scene in Minneapolis, essentially aiding and abetting. And Derek Chauvin's charges were elevated to second-degree murder. Joe Roddy says such charges make them all more or less accountable for Floyd's death. This, as protesters continue to fill city and suburban streets from coast to coast, begging for more to be done.
More education for officers, more police reform overall, and more training, not just in Minneapolis, but in departments across the country. Julie Unruh, WGN News.